Welcome, fellow adventurers, to Explore Travel Capture. My name is Paul Dillon, and today we're going to be reviewing the Rome Adventure Company rooftop tent. So I'm going to quickly show you how easy it is to set up, and then we'll dive into a little bit of the details. So first things first, we want to unzip the rain cover. But in order to do that, you need to just unclip. Each side has two clips. Now that we've got the rain cover unzipped, I will peel this up here just so you can see the zipper. The zippers on these things I've already felt are really, really thick and nice. When you zip it up, you can kind of be a little aggressive with it. They don't feel cheaply made at all. So when I put this away, the zipper does have a pull strap on it. I like to just tuck this into the Velcro so it's not flapping in the wind. But now that we've got it unclipped, we simply just need to unzip it. I will say the only downside to this tent is if your arms aren't super lanky like mine, you will need to step on the tire or step on the door, but it's still very easy, as you can see, to unzip. Now that we've got the cover unzipped, you need to just take off the road cover to reveal the actual tent. Now, even though I'm very, very tall, it's still kind of difficult to reach, but you can always just pull down from the material here. You've got a couple different ways that you can store this. You can actually roll it up, which is pretty nifty. And then you can use these straps to kind of tuck it under. But I'll explain why I leave this let down in just a second. So now that the road cover is off, we need to unclip the actual tent itself. Now the nice thing about this is even if your arms aren't super long, you can reach these Velcro straps without actually climbing on the car. But as you can see, it's strapped to my Subaru Crosstrek. If you had a 4Runner, you might have to actually get a ladder or climb on top of the actual tent itself. Now, in order to actually open the tent, you need to unclip the ladder. This is something I'm gonna have to stand on the car for because I can't reach the middle of this tent. So I usually just stand on my tire and that gives me enough space to unvelcro the ladder from the roof. And then the ladder is just gonna pull out. Honestly, my all-time favorite feature of this tent is once the ladder is locked, you simply just lift up the tent. And it's that easy. There is some slight adjustments you need to do to the ladder because this is not a load-bearing ladder. And I'll actually explain, I thought there was an issue with my tent originally when I set it up because the top of this ladder actually moves. So let me adjust the ladder a bit and I'll show you why I thought this tent had an issue with it. According to Rome Adventure Company, you never want to start at the bottom rung of the ladder. You always want to start at the top. So there's two clips that lock this in. So when you press these in, you can actually move this forward until you get it about a 45, I think they say about a 15 degree angle. So this looks pretty good. Now, if you want to show this section here, this is why I thought this tent had an issue with it to begin with. Because if you move this tent up and down, you actually see how this moves. I actually contacted Rome Adventure Company because I thought there was an issue with the tent. Turns out they do that, so not only do you, just in case your car isn't fully level, when you move around at night, this actually doesn't damage the ladder because it kind of works like suspension in your car. So when you move around at night and you roll, maybe it's really windy and the tent moves, it actually doesn't put stress on the ladder and it doesn't break the ladder. That's realistically it. Now we can put the rain fly on, which we'll do, but it's that quick. It took me longer to explain what I was doing than to actually set up the tent. So while setting up the tent, I said there was a reason why I leave this down instead of actually rolling it up and tucking it under. When setting this tent up, you have the ability to kind of flip the tent around. You can have it open, as you see here, to the passenger side of your car or the driver's side. But when I set it up, I didn't realize that the road mat, you can actually flip to the other side. So if it was flipped to the other side, I would absolutely roll it up real nice. But the reason why you can't roll it up on this side is because it keeps the tent from actually laying flat. The nice thing about this tent is it has these nice slide rails on it. So not only can I add extra storage space, like you see here, it's easy to just remove the road cover because it slides right in this rail. A lot of you might be wondering, well, what does it look like inside and how much space does it have? So let's take a look. So I am 6'2", and you'll notice here that I have a little bit of space on this end and a little bit of space on the other end. So I would say if you're bigger than 6'2", like 6'3" and above, you might want to consider getting their bigger tent. But as you can tell, I have quite a bit of room on either side of the sleeping bag to kind of roll around and move. And there's a lot of space. I can sit up when I sleep. We've got the two sunroofs up there. I was a little too lazy, so I didn't roll the actual material up, so they're just open. But as you can tell, there's plenty of space and plenty of pockets. Now that we're back home from our adventure, let's go over some of the details. We'll talk about the pros and cons and who I think this tent is for. In terms of who I think the rooftop tent is for, I really think it's going to be subjective, and I bet it varies from person to person. So I will just share my personal experience on why I invested in the Rome Adventure Company rooftop tent. Now, I specifically chose the Vagabond Lite. It is the smaller brother of the three tents that they offer. I have a Subaru Crosstrek, so it's a fairly small vehicle, so I didn't want to slap a very large tent on a very small car. I chose the rooftop tent because I am someone who camps quite frequently, sometimes 2 to 3 times a month. 99% of the time, I backcountry camp because I am a landscape photographer and I don't like to be around other campers, other noise, other light pollution, or flashlights and headlights. And I've often found when I camp, in a tent at least, it's very hard. Sometimes you can't stake the tent down and you have struggle trying to find rocks to help you weigh the tent down. And even with my gear, when I'm sleeping at night, the tent's moving around and flapping around because it's not staked. And I can attest to not having a good night's sleep, especially if you're staying somewhere for a couple of days, is the worst experience. You don't want to hike around, you don't want to take photos, you're in the worst of moods. It's just not a great experience. Sleep is the utmost importance. So after a few years of losing sleep, I thought it was time to invest in the rooftop tent. So far, after sleeping in that tent, some of the best sleep I've ever had camping. I mean, that huge 3-inch pad, I was a little afraid at first because it's mounted on top of the car. When I moved around, that the car would kind of rock and sway. When you're in that thing moving around, you don't really even know you're mounted to the top of a car. It's surprisingly very solid. There's not a lot of movement, not a lot of sound. I don't hear the suspension moving around when I'm moving around. You can't tell, there's no like roof noise. Now let's talk about some of the cons. As you can imagine, having a tent strapped to the roof, it's gonna add some weight. The Vagabond Lite comes in at about 110 pounds assembled. That's with the road cover. So you can imagine with a full-size spare, all my gear, a couple days worth of food, maybe even another person with me, you're gonna take a little bit of a gas mileage hit. Now, gas mileage will vary for person to person, from car to car. It depends on a ton of variables. But for me specifically, with the Methods and the big tires that I have, I lost about a 6 to 8 mile, I took about a 6 to 8 mile a gallon hit. Now, knowing this now, would I still invest in a rooftop tent in the future? I absolutely would. The sleep is worth it for me. So taking a 6 to 8 mile an hour hit on gas, it's not that big a deal for me. Yeah, it sucks, but I'd rather have a good night's sleep. Realistically, that's the only con that I've seen so far. Now, I've only had this tent for a couple months, so maybe something may change in the future and I might update this video as things arise, but that's the only con I've had. Assembling the tent was pretty easy. I just cut the box open and laid it out flat, so I had kind of a clean area to work on. I opened the tent and flipped it back and forth. I would say the hardest part was getting my hand between the anti-sweat mat and the actual sleeping pad to get the nuts for the mount rail. But even that wasn't a pain in the ass. You just got to use a little bit of elbow grease and get it in there. But the assembly, I was able to do it myself. Now, installing it on the vehicle, I did call a friend down to help me lift it. Again, I have a Subaru Crosstrek, which isn't a really tall vehicle, even with the lift kit. So you can imagine if you had a Tacoma or a 4Runner or a big truck, it might be a little bit more difficult to install yourself. But even in that case, you might get a couple of people and that makes that thing a little lighter and easier to lift over your head. Assembly was easy, installation was easy, and as you can tell from the intro in this video, actually opening up the tent is very, very easy. The only thing you gotta do and be mindful of when you're setting it up is just try to get your vehicle level. It doesn't have to be absolutely perfect. You don't have to get a level out, but the more even it is, the more beneficial it's going to be so you're not sleeping on an incline or putting an utmost stress on the actual tent itself. So with that being said, we can discuss why I chose Rome Adventure Company over any other companies. I will say first and foremost that I am not sponsored. They are not paying me to make this video. They don't even know I'm making this video. They have no say so in this video whatsoever. But at the end of the day, it came down to customer service. I emailed a bunch of different rooftop tent companies and I felt like Rome Adventure Company just actually gave a shit. Their customer service was super cool. They never made me felt like I was a dumb question or no question was too big or too small. They always reassured me that, hey, we get it. This is a big investment and we want you to feel comfortable with the purchase. Even after I bought the tent, I had some shipping questions and they were more than happy to answer all of those questions. In fact, as I talked about in the beginning of the video with the ladder moving, I emailed them. They actually called me right away and just explained to me that, hey, that's an actual feature. It's not made to be locked down, otherwise the tent could take damage and cause damage to the actual ladder. So that reassured me. They were more than happy to just hop on the phone and make sure I knew everything that was going on with the tent. And it's just little things like those that matter at the end of the day, especially because these rooftop tents are not cheap, which leads me to my next point. So I chose the Vagabond Light. That tent starts at $1,549. That's before tax and shipping. They also make the Vagabond tent, which is just a little bit, you can kind of look at the Light as the smaller tent. The Vagabond is like the middle tent. That tent starts at $1,949 before tax and shipping. And then they have the Vagabond XL, which starts at $2,299 before tax and shipping. So as you can see, this is a pretty large investment. But now knowing all the ins and outs of these tents, the costs, the pros, the cons, the ins and outs, the ease for installation, let me know in the comments below if you're going to invest in a rooftop tent. Or maybe you already own a new rooftop tent. What version, what brand do you own? Why did you choose that company? And why do you love the rooftop tent so much? Thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you guys in the next video.